Now let us look at this question. They are saying, define the connective star for two valued variables A, B and C as follows. A star B is equal to AB plus A complement B complement, and let C is equal to A star B. They are saying C is equal to A star B. Now determine which of the following is valid. First is A is equal to B star C, B is equal to A star C, A star B star C is equal to 1. They are asking which of the following is valid. Okay. So let us, first of all, we know what is C. C can be written as A star B, which is equal to AB plus A complement B complement. They have already given this. If we take C complement, then it can be written as A star B whole complement, which is AB plus A complement B complement whole complement, which can be, you can apply De Morgan's law on this. So if you apply De Morgan's law, you can say it is AB complement dot A complement B complement whole complement. Further, you can expand it, so it can be written as A complement plus B complement dot, here also you can expand it, so it can be written as A plus B whole complement complement, which is equal to A complement plus B complement dot AB. Now if you open these brackets, so it can be written like this: A complement dot A plus A complement dot B plus B complement dot A plus B complement dot B. And you know what is A complement dot A and what is B complement dot B. This is equal to 0 and this is also equal to 0. So it can be written as A complement dot B plus B complement dot A. So this is C complement. Okay, so I am finding C and C complement initially because these values I will be utilizing while I will be solving this question. Okay, so first part is they are saying prove that which of the following is valid. So first part is they are saying A is equal to B star C. A is equal to B star C. Is it valid or not? Okay, so this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. Let us take the right hand side first, RHS. Right hand side is B star C. And here they are using a star operator, hence it can be written as B dot C plus B complement dot C complement. Now you know why I have already calculated what is C and C complement. I can just put these values over there. So if I put these values, it can be written as B dot AB plus A complement B complement, which is the value of C, plus B complement dot, and the value of C complement is A complement B plus AB complement. So further it can be written like this, open the brackets, A dot B plus A complement dot B complement dot B plus A complement dot B complement plus A B complement dot B complement. So it can be written as AB plus, here you take, we have B complement dot B which is equal to 0, so it is A complement dot 0 plus, here you can we have B dot B complement which is equal to 0, so it can be written as A complement dot 0 plus A B complement. Further it can be written as AB plus AB complement plus 0 plus 0. You can take A as common between these two, so it is A B plus B complement which is equal to A dot 1 which is equal to A, and this is equal to the left hand side of this question. So you can say this one is valid, the first one is valid. Now let us take the second one. Second one is saying we have B is equal to A star C. B is equal to A star C. Is it valid or not? Let us take the right hand side. This is the right hand side. Right hand side says we have A star C. So it can be expanded like this: A dot C plus A complement dot C complement. And you know what is the value of C and C complement? Put these values here. So it can be written as A dot AB plus A complement B complement plus A complement dot A complement B plus AB complement. Further, it can also be written like this. We have A dot B plus A dot A complement dot B complement plus A complement dot B plus A complement dot A dot B complement. It is equal to AB. This is 0. So it is plus B complement dot 0 plus this is equal to A complement dot B plus this is equal to 0. So it is B complement dot 0, which is equal to AB plus A complement B plus 0 plus 0. Further, you can take B as common between these two. So it can be written as A plus A complement, which is equal to B dot 1, which is equal to D itself. Hence, the option, this second part is also valid. This is also valid. Now let us take the third part. Third part is saying, this one may be might tricky as compared to the previous one. So it is saying we have A star B star C is equal to 1. A star B star C is equal to 1. So now let us take the left hand side here in this case. Left hand side. It is saying we have A star B star C. You can associate according to your preference, but let us say I'm going to expand this one first, B star C, just for example, okay? So there is no associativity defined in this case. So I'm just going to expand this one first. So it is A star. What is B star C? Or yes, there's one more, there's a better way of writing this, right? So let me just do it again. We already know that A star B is AB plus A complement B complement. And C can be written as A star B, right? And here in this case, we already have A star B. So it can also be written like this. It is C star C. So if we have C star C, now put these values into this. So we will get C dot C plus C complement dot C complement, which is equal to C plus C complement, which is equal to 1. So it is one of the most easiest one, right? Fine. So now let us take few more examples of these kind of questions, and then we'll move on to what are functional properties in case of digital logic, or you can say in case of switching algebra.